Hi everyone, in this video we will discuss how to generate e-certificates using Google Form for online courses and webinars. First of all, we have to log in to Google Drive. Now open a Google form. Next step is to install the add-on Certify'em. For that, we have to go to the three-dot menu on the top right corner. Click on the button add-on. Here we can see a list of add-ons available. From this list, we can select the add-on Certify'em. Install the add-on. You have to choose the Gmail account. Give permission to install the add-on. Now the installation is complete. Now you can see an icon here. This is the add-on icon. By clicking here, you can see the list of add-ons available. See, Certify'em is available in this Google form. Now you have to enable Certify'em in this course. Certify'em is now enabled for use in this course. A window will be pop up on the right side of the screen. This is the Certify'em control menu. For the time being, I am closing this window. The next step is to add the identifier questions. The first identifier question is email address. This is required to mail the certificate to participants if they pass. This question must always appear first. The second identifier question is full name. This will be a short answer type question. This is to correct the name of the participant for printing on e-certificate. We can also add one or two other identifier questions to collect additional information such as designation and name of institution. These should be the third and fourth questions. That is immediately after the full name question. We should not assign any point to these questions. Once Certify'em sees a question that assigns points, it will stop looking for the other identifiers. These two, designation and name of institution, are optional. Now we can add the content of examinations. Here comes the title of exam. Then, after all the identifier questions, such as full name, designation, and name of institution, we can add the questions for evaluation. Here, I have already added two questions for evaluation. Now, we have to assign points to these questions. Also, we can provide answer key for evaluation. Now, this Google form is ready for conducting examination. Then, open the Certify'em control menu. The next step is to choosing a passing percent. By default, it is set to 80%. We can use the Certify'em pop-up menu to select a passing percentage from the passing drop-down menu. If exam takers score this percentage or higher, they will be emailed a certificate. By default, the passing percentage is set to 80%. But we can choose any value between 0 and 100. Here I am going to select 60%. We can select a certificate template from the template drop-down menu. Each certificate will contain the exam taker's full name, their other identifiers, and a 7-digit serial number, which is called certificate ID. If you want to see how a certificate will look for your exam, choose a template and then click the link "Email me sample." You will receive a sample PDF certificate by email. Here is the mail containing sample certificate. This is the certificate. Here comes the name of the participant, name of the institution. Here is the title of exam. This is the date of examination and passing score. And here is the certificate ID. You can also use your own custom template. To create your own custom template, select Use a Custom Template option at the bottom of Template drop-down menu.
Generation of e-certificates using custom template is explained in the next video. Its link is given in the description box. After selecting a past person and certificate template, click Turn On at the top of the Certify'em pop-up menu. Now the certification is on for this examination. You can turn it off whenever you want by clicking this link. Here is the link to your examination. You can share it to your participants. You can also share the link to this examination by clicking the tab Send on the top right corner of the Google form. You can either invite by sending email or sharing URL of the Google form. This is the URL of the Google form. We can shorten this URL. And this URL can be shared via WhatsApp or Telegram group. We can also invite the participant to take part in this examination by sending an email containing the link to this examination. Invitation by email is not preferred because for a normal Gmail account, we can send 100 mails per day. So if we have more than 100 participants, we have to send the certificates in different steps. 100 certificates in first day, next 100 certificates in the second day, like that. If you are using a G Suite account, the limit is 1,500. You can send up to 1,500 mails per day. So better way to share the link is copy the URL and share it to the participants via WhatsApp groups or Telegram groups. Now we can attempt this examination and check whether the certificate will be generated or not. This is the email containing invitation. We can fill out the form. We can enter the personal information first. After filling up the personal information, we can go to the examination. After finishing the examination, click Submit. We have submitted the examination successfully. If our score is greater than the passing score, we will get a certificate in the inbox. We can check it now. Here is the certificate. This is the name of the participant. This is the designation. This is the name of institution. These three fields are given by the participants while taking part in the examination. This is the title of examination, date of examination, and the passing score. Here is the certificate ID. In this way, we can generate e-certificates for the participants of courses, examinations, and webinars using the add-on Certify'em in the Google form. Thank you.